All right, so this is for 6th, 7th, and 8th grade, and we will be allowing 5th graders who are interested to come and try out for this as well, okay? Audition dates, December 14th. That's when we will start doing auditions for this show. Starts right after school, thank you. Right after school, 4 o'clock, we'll be in the auditorium. We'll probably start around the band room or the auditorium, but we will call you over from that. This will be for East and West Minico as well as fifth grade from any of the elementary schools if they're interested, okay? That might be limited depending on how many people we have as far as fifth graders go, okay? If we have way too many people that we can't really fit them on stage, we might have to limit how many fifth graders we have come. So December 14th, we have a thing called boot camp, okay? That's not Army boot camp, it's theater boot camp, where Mrs. Birch and I will talk to you about some of the methods of acting and performing on stage. Notice how I'm facing you right now. If I was talking to you like this, that would be really weird, right? But you'd be surprised how many kids, their first time on stage, just kind of turn like this and talk with their backs to the audience. So we'll talk about things like that. So anyone who shows up to boot camp and comes and goes through the boot camp will automatically be allowed in the show, okay? This is sort of like sports. You have to have grades, you have to have behavior, have to have attendance where it's supposed to be. So if you have two Fs, if you have below a 2.0 GPA, then we have those conversations about whether or not you can actually do this. So like I said, you're automatically in if you come to boot camp unless you've got issues with grades or attendance and those sorts of things. But the next day, December 15th, if you want to audition for a lead role, some people are okay just being like, it's like, you know what, I just want to be part of the chorus or part of the townspeople or whatever, and that's fine. But if you want to be a lead role, you want to try and play the part of the genie or Jasmine or something like that, then you will come the next day on the 15th, prepare a song, and sing the song for us. And we'll probably ask you to do a few kind of acting things, but you don't have to prepare. A lot of times, you're supposed to prepare like a monologue where you speak something. We probably won't make you do that, like have something memorized, but we'll probably have you say something like Mary Had a Little Lamb, but have you do it in certain personalities, right? So if you have questions, just save them to the end. Callbacks. So if we have a whole bunch of people audition for lead roles and we're having trouble deciding, we will use the third day, so December 16th will be the third day for callbacks. And that's just for us to ask you to do a few more things and try and sort out who we think is going to work best together for those parts that we're doing. We will then have a parent information meeting the next Monday on December 20th at 4 o'clock. Now, I will also post that parent information meeting on Facebook Live because I know some parents probably can't get off work by 4 o'clock. So if they can come, great, but if they can't, then they can get that information on Facebook Live. So in relation to that, there's a few people who will have a few questions as far as what interferes. First of all, this will not interfere with Ski Club, okay? If you were thinking about Ski Club and the play, thing is, I'm driving the bus for Ski Club, so I can't necessarily direct the play and drive the bus. So we will not be having rehearsals on Thursdays until after Ski Club is over. Let's see, so Mr. Larson will be happy about that. So if you were planning on doing Ski Club, you can do that. Also, this will not interfere with track, okay? This won't interfere, so if you're planning on trying out for track, the track team, the very last week when we're doing performances is kind of the first week of track, so you might miss a practice or two of track, but it won't interfere majorly with anything like that. If you are going out for the boys basketball team and you make the team, you're not going to be able to do both. That's just how it goes, okay? So typically the rehearsals are Monday through Wednesday. Lead roles will be asked to come in on Friday mornings. So if you are playing the part of Aladdin or Jasmine or Genie or the Sultan or something, you will probably be coming in on Friday mornings to run your lines and your blocking on that. Performances will be the week of March 15th through the 19th, okay? That's like right before spring break. So it's gonna be kind of a crazy week right there, but we'll probably do several performances here during the day for East Minico students, because that auditorium holds about 250 people maybe, maybe not even that much. So we'll probably just do it by like a 6th, 7th, and 8th grade performance, and then we'll do our nighttime performances. We might be doing a matinee performance on Friday or Saturday. We haven't decided on that, okay? Transportation, you stay here after school and your parents are responsible for getting you home. So make sure you have that worked out however you want to do that. We talked about eligibility. And then tech and backstage help. I know some people might be interested in helping out with that stuff, okay? So if you're interested in, if you're like, hey, I'm not a sing and dance sort of person, I don't really want to be in the spotlight, then great, that's excellent. We will probably only have a limited amount of people who can help with tech and backstage, okay? So the light person, there's not a lot to do with lights. There's only a few buttons, and it's like turn on the lights and turn off the lights, you know? So we really only need one person for that. We probably need another person who kind of starts and stops the music. It's gonna be on a track, probably on an iPad, and that person will start the music at the right times and then stop the music at the right times. That's a way more important role than you think it might be. But that sort of thing will be, we'll have to, if we have like 20 people come out and wanna do that, we'll probably have to pick and choose who gets to do that and who is responsible enough for that. Does that make sense? We can also use help with props, which are like the items that the characters have. Like, you know, does anyone have a magic lamp in their house? Like, a nice, and see, some people might have that. But it's like, that's a prop, okay? And we need to get a nice looking magic lamp for Aladdin. So things like that, we might need people to help hunt those things down. We could also really desperately use help from parents, whether that's with costumes or with bringing food for the staff, for the cast and things like that. So we could definitely use help from parents. We will ask for parents to sign up for that during the parent meeting the Monday after auditions, okay? And the last thing I want to talk about, and it's not on this sheet, but sponsorships. We will be asking you to go home to your family members, and like if you have, you know, a dad or an uncle or someone who, you know, owns a landscaping business, we would love for them to send their advertising, their logo, so we can put it in the program, and then they can pay us like $50 towards our production. It's like a nice trade-off, okay? It's like we're thinking like $25, $50 that they could give so that we can then pay for things like costumes. It costs about $1,000 just for us to start the show, okay? Just for us, and that doesn't include the cost of costumes and set and other things. So it's almost $1,000 that Mr. Durant was nice enough to say, yes, you guys can use that, and then we're supposed to pay him back at the end. So we'll be selling lots of tickets, hopefully, okay? Okay, now I need to know if you have questions that refer to kind of the general group of people. Okay, I saw your hand first.
So if we already have acting experience,
this is a good question. If you've already been on stage and you've already had acting experience, do you need to go to boot camp? The answer is yes. I want everyone to come. And it's not because we don't think that you don't know what you're doing, it's because we want to see who's committed to coming to the show. Now, I will clarify one thing. Is boot camp absolutely 100% required for you to make the show? No, but if you don't come and then you come audition the next day, it's probably less likely that you get a part, okay? It's sort of like boys are doing open gym tonight to kind of get practiced up for basketball season, and if they don't show up to open gym, they're less likely to make the team because they haven't been practicing. Does that make sense? So is it required? No. If you are just this powerhouse and you can come out and blow us away in one audition and you didn't do the boot camp, maybe you get the part. So, okay, other questions?
Do you
What if the people that want to do backstage help get the same role as the people that are being on stage?
I'm not sure I understand your question. So, are you saying that they have to come the same amount of times and stuff? Is that what you're saying?
No, like, would they get the same paper?
Oh, like this paper here?
Yeah.
Yes, I give this to everyone, whether you want to be backstage or on stage. Other question.
So this sponsor thing, so can it be like more than $50?
They can pay me as much money as they want to sponsor this program. Yes, I would pay.
$50.
If they want to pay me $1 million, yeah, we'll be able to put on shows for years to come. Okay, but yeah, we're typically asking for that $25 to $50 sponsorship.
So $5,000 would work.
It would work, yes. I mean,
thanks, Micah.
I'd see if I can make room in the bank account for $5,000. But yes,
we'd gladly
love to. Understand that whatever money we make on this will go to next year's show. And yes, we are thinking next year we're going to do another show. So we're going to put it into a account for plays, musicals, which we don't have yet, but we're going to make an account because we're going to make money on this, hopefully. Yes. Okay, Talia.
What if you kind of sleep in the Friday?
So if you, let's say you have a lead role and we ask you to come on Friday, 8 o'clock, or you know, like, and then you don't make it and you don't come, okay? So I will be pretty clear about this. If you miss 3 practices, we're gonna have a conversation, and that's not just Fridays, but that's any day. If you miss 3 practices, we're gonna have a conversation about whether or not you want to be in this show, okay? Which is a very nice way of saying you might get kicked out.